the wrong form number. The dates were completely out of whack.
You're telling us the usurper president, Barack Hussein Obama, has forged selective service documents?
Well, I cannot say if he personally forged it or he
but he's
used,
using.
But according to the federal agent by name Stephen Kaufman that has provided this report, this is a forged document, and there are numerous reasons and numerous explanations and justifications why it is a forged document. Additionally, certification of live birth that he posted on the internet, according to two experts, there are numerous signs of forgery on the selective service certificate.
Are you a private investigator? What is your background? I mean, people are going to wonder what is, because not everybody in our viewing area here nor in Europe is going to know who Dr. Orly Tates is.
I'm an attorney, and I'm representing now 150 plaintiffs. Most of my plaintiffs are high-ranked officers of the U.S. military, starting with Major General Childers. Aside from that, and I have colonels and lieutenant colonels from all branches of the military, Air Force.
And these officers of our military are concerned about what?
They're stating that we need to verify Mr. Obama's eligibility to be the president and commander-in-chief, because according to the documents that we have, he is not eligible. Additionally, I have 10 state representatives from all over the country.
First of all, what law school did you go to?
Taft University.
Taft University Law School.
Yes, this is William Howard Taft. It's a different Taft University.
Okay.
And I passed California Bar.
You passed the bar. What year?
6 years ago.
6 years ago. And you lived somewhere in the San Diego area?
Orange County, South Orange
County.
And I have dual degrees, both. I've been a dentist for over 20 years.
You were a dentist?
Yes.
I need a root canal. Right. Maybe we can work a deal.
Well, listen,
here.
I can tell you, I know one person that I'm eager to do a root canal.
I think we better not go there.
Yeah. I can guess who that was.
And you wouldn't believe how many people want to be my dental assistant on this one.
Without anesthesia, too. No numbing.
We ran out of anesthesia. Keep drilling. Keep drilling. Just be tough. You're a tough man. You can take a drill.
Yeah, we take all of that.
We have to drill for the truth. So you were a dentist, then you decided to become an attorney.
Yeah, and I can hurt more than one way.
Okay. Why did you get concerned about this? I mean, you were born where?
I was born in Russia.
Russia.
And that's why I'm so concerned. About 6 years ago, so I've been a licensed attorney for 6 years in the state.
And you're still
of California.
Doing dentistry.
I still do, but less now with this case. I've been pretty busy, so I haven't been doing.
I would think so. And has Barack Obama invited you to the White Oval Office and say, hey, Dr. Tate, sit down, let's have a talk? Has he done that?
I should live so long.
Let's hope, let's pray you do live long. Okay, so that helps our viewers know a little bit about your background, because be honest, Dr. Orly Tates is not exactly a household name yet, like Anderson Pooper. I mean, Scooper. What's that guy's name?
Cooper.
Cooper, yes. Anderson. But he has so much of that pooey stuff that he throws out there, like most Fox reporters and CNN. This is a Fox-free zone, people, a CNN-free zone. No spin here. Well, that helps us a lot. But you did the most amazing journey. How much notice did you have that Chief Justice John Roberts was going to be speaking at the University of Idaho before you took off and went up there? How much notice?
Well, I knew it for a few days.
For a few days?
Yeah.
And you just packed up, left everything, got on a plane, flew to Seattle, drove a car over to Idaho.
Actually, it was even longer than that. You know, I had to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning. If they don't do it, and we demanded an answer from Eric Holder, Attorney General, if he does not investigate this, if he does not institute quo warranto, I, or actually my plaintiffs, step in the shoes of the Attorney General and bring the case. And we, there are a couple of precedents that two senators, one was Senator Gallatin, I believe in 1793, and another was Senator Shield in 1864, were removed from office because they had quo warranto proceedings, and probably the system wasn't that dirty and that rigged then. And they removed them from office. The election was annulled. It was null and void, as if they were never elected. They had a special election.
This was what year?
1793 and 1864, if I'm not mistaken.
It's a bit of a long time. It's like 100 and 200 years ago.
Yeah, things went down the hill since then.
Maybe we should have done this more often in the interim.
Absolutely.
Okay, so we get rid of Obama. And I was very impressed by not the quality of the video on YouTube of you, but the content of your message, that you cited this guy whose name was
Emmerich Debattel.
Emmerich Debattel. And in his Law of the Nations Encyclopedia, which was prevalent at the time of the founding of America, the United States of America, naturally born meant you could be born, as you said, in the White House, but if your parents weren't citizens, you weren't a citizen.
Absolutely. And the law never changed. As a matter of fact, last year, when Senate wanted to check eligibility of John McCain, Senator Leahy, the chair of the Judicial Committee, has announced, and I'm paraphrasing, but he announced that Senator McCain is eligible to run for president. He's a natural-born citizen because both of his parents were U.S. citizens, and he was born in the territory of Panama Canal, which is a U.S. territory. So he explained to the Senate and populace that it's a two-pronged test. Two parents have to be citizens, and the person that wants to be president has to be born in the United States. And so it's the same law from Vattel to today, all the same, nothing changed.
So McCain qualified either?
He qualified because both of his parents were U.S. citizens and he was born in the area of Panama Canal, which is a U.S. territory. The problem with Obama is that his father was never a U.S. citizen. He never even had a green card. He was here on student visa.
Yeah, that's right. It's interesting. Both Obama and his father both went to Harvard. And now we've got a usurper who graduated from Harvard. And I'm just wondering, is there something tainted in the water at Harvard? is there something that just makes these people squirrely?
Well, it's something interesting. I think maybe because of his Harvard education, he knew that he does not qualify. So on his website, Fight the Smears, which I call Fight the Truth, smear everyone who dares to speak up the truth. That's his real motto. He put down that people are saying that I'm not a native-born citizen. It's interesting that he changed it. He didn't write that I'm not a natural-born, which is a requirement to be president. He's written, I'm not native-born. Why? Because he knew that he's not a natural-born citizen. There is no way he can call himself natural. So he kind of twisted it around.
That's what they do. They use different words. Even with McCain, they didn't say he was natural-born. They said he was a citizen at birth. They never went so far as to declare that McCain is qualified in because he's natural-born. They said he's a citizen at birth because of both his parents. And you know, and if you look at the Department of State, it says very clearly, a U.S. military base and a U.S. embassy is not American soil.